Okay, everyone, let's get started. I'm Dr. Wallman, but you can call me Sheila. Now, we all know why we're here. Let's begin by saying hello to our new members. Tom, why don't you go first?
Hi, my name is Tom Sutton. I'm 44 years old, and I still live at home.
Very good. Next.
Hi, I'm Reggie Noble. I'm 31 years old, and I still live at home.
Mark?
I'm Mark, 38.
Is there anything else you'd like to add to that, Mark?
No, I'm not ready yet.
That's okay. That's fine. And Paul?
I'm Paul Restrepo. I'm 48 years old. I'm still living at home, and I have no intention of ever leaving.
Okay, Tom. Why don't we start with you? You're smart, you have a job, you seem secure, and yet you still live at home.
Well, with today's economy, you have to admit the present financial climate's not conducive to taking any risky personal ventures.
Like moving out of your mother's house?
Exactly.
But aren't you a successful doctor?
Well, yeah, but you know, you never know how long this medicine thing's gonna last.
Okay, now, Reggie, you told me you planned on moving out, but your mother called me before the meeting and said you just built a private entrance to your room.
Well, Dr. Wallman, I'm gonna let you in on something. Privacy is very important to a man.
So do you plan on ever leaving?
Whoa, whoa. Now, lady, I'm what you might call a realist. Sooner or later, my parents are gonna die and leave me the house. Now, why should I move all my stuff out when I'm gonna have to just move it all back in? I mean, my parents are gonna probably die real soon. I mean, they eat pretty bad, they don't exercise, lots of fatty foods. I mean, the other day, a doctor found a lump on my mother's ass. I mean, who knows what that could be?
Okay, now, Mark, you're still living with your mother.
No. We're roommates, we share an apartment.
Oh, so you're living with her?
No. She found this great new apartment, and she needed a roommate to help cover the rent, so I moved in.
Oh, so you're paying rent?
No, she's paying my half of the rent, but I'm gonna pay her back, I swear it.
All right, now, Paul, you're also staying with your mother.
Staying with her? Lady, I'm living with her. I live with my mother. It's great. Last week, I even got one of those little refrigerators in my room that makes ice. I ain't going nowhere.
Okay, let's just try to get to the root of the problem here.
I'll tell you the problem. The problem is the kind of rent you have to pay today. That's the problem.
That's right. Yeah. That's right. My whole life, my parents pay for everything. Now, all of a sudden, I'm the one who's supposed to pay? That's not fair.
I have a friend who has to pay $300 rent for his place.
Yeah, that's 300% more than I pay.
Don't look at me. My friend does it.
I guess his mama doesn't love him.
Gentlemen, most men do agree that at a certain point in their lives, they do have a desire to go out on their own, move into their own place.
You know, that may sound good, but tell me this. Who's gonna cut my meat into little pieces when I move out, huh?
Your mom still has to cut your meat for you? What's wrong with this guy here? I mean,
Now, hold on, Tom. I'm sure your mother helps out in certain ways.
I know mine sure does.
Well, what exactly does she do, Mr. Restrepo?
I got that woman cooking, cleaning, answering phone calls, driving me places. Where am I going? I'm living the sweet life.
Okay, let's move on. How about women, relationships?
Well, that's easy. If a woman wants to come home with me, I just tell her I'm in town for a few days and I'm staying with my parents, that's all.
My mommy says, all women want is to get pregnant so they could steal me away from the one person who really loves me so that she's left all alone. That's what mommy says.
Well, my mom says there's only one thing more pathetic than a grown man that lives at home. And that's any woman willing to sneak into his room.
Well, so what does that tell you?
Well, you know, maybe it's time I made the big move. It's about that time I made that big move to the basement.
What about you, Paul?
Well, some women don't like my bunk bed. But, hey, where's my brother gonna sleep?
Oh, excuse me, everyone. Come in.
Hi, Ma. I'm sorry to interrupt, but can I borrow the car keys?
Oh, sure. They're in the top dresser drawer.
Oh, thanks. I love you, Ma.
I love you, too. You know, tonight's the first time he's going to the circus alone. I'm so proud.